that walks in here.
Yeah.
Praise the Lord. Amen. Elder Hollis, I don't know if you want me to give you a testimony or not, but maybe you better get it. Praise the Lord.
Something like that, but it's a, in other words, it's a mini stroke. But I'm claiming the victory today. I'm very tired, very weak, but with God, I'm strong.
Amen.
And I was determined, hallelujah, to make it here today.
Amen.
To celebrate the resurrection of my Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ.
Amen.
Because nobody that I know of that has ever lived or will ever live has suffered like my Lord Jesus Christ suffered for us.
Yes.
And there are people that still hate him. There's people that still don't want to praise him. But God did it for you.
Yes.
But he said, no, you got more work to do. And, you know, it affected the left side of my body, but I'm getting stronger every minute. And it's a little hard still going up steps, but I made it here. And with my, and I want to say this, too, before I sit down. I have one of the most wonderful, blessed, gifted, powerful bishops and pastors that I ever knew.
Amen.
And will ever know. I truly believe that. I know there's other people that have power and are gifted and all that, but I'm talking about me, what I've experienced.
Amen.
And I thank God that she prayed day and night for me.
Did what he needed to do, put all those valves back in and cleared him up, amen, and took her heart off the shelf, prayed her heart out of ice and put it back in her body.
Amen.
She got scarred out that long, praise God. But so she believes God. Come on, say amen.
Amen.
Amen. So I trust God, amen, for all of y'all in here today. Come on, say amen.
Amen.
And if the truth be told, everybody needs something from God.
Amen.
On a daily basis.
Amen.
I need his strength.
Hallelujah.
I need his help.
Yeah.
Oh, God. I need his guidance. I need his direction. I need his counsel. I need his love. I need his love. I need his joy. I need everything that God can give me. All that I need is in Jesus. Loving, understanding God.
Yes.
Oh God, who knows all about my needs before I even know I need it. But he promised me in his word that he would supply all of my needs.
Yes.
Come on,
church. Yes.
There's so much that can be said about this glorious Savior today and the very fact that he rose victorious. And when he rose victorious over death, hell, and the grave.
Amen.
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 He took charge of everything and everybody and every situation that needed to be taken care of.
Amen.
I want you to know that there were stages that Jesus went through before to Calvary.
Amen.
They did some horrendous things to him that was really not necessary because he didn't deserve what he suffered.
Yes.
He didn't deserve to go through all that he went through, but, you know, I'm going to hit some places today, praise the Lord, I'm going to hit some spots, amen, we're going to move on, and we're just going to tell you how great he really is, and give you a somewhat of a panoramic view of really what he suffered.
Amen.
Now, as Elder Holland alluded to the fact that I don't know anyone that died a death like he did.
Amen.
Yeah. Anybody know somebody that died in the more horrendous than Jesus died? No, he went through some stuff. And the fact of the matter is a lot of people go through things and they deserve it.
Amen.
Hello?
Amen.
But Jesus didn't deserve nothing. He went through, because he went through all that he went through for us.
Amen.
He bore our grief.
Yes.
He bore our sin. Oh my God.
Yes.
Everything that he went through for you and I.
Yes.
Yes. Oh my God. So, let me get into the word of God here. I want to start here, I think, in chapter 26. Of Matthew. Let's go there right quick, if you don't mind. I'm not going to wear your patience this morning. Praise the Lord. We're not going to be here all morning long. Amen.
Amen.
No sin found in him. Oh, God, help me. Who would be? I'll be talking about the good death, burial, and resurrection for the next 6 months. Amen. Praise the Lord. Because there's more that can be said about the resurrection of Jesus than in one half an hour or 35 minutes.
Amen.
Y'all believe that?
Amen.
All right. In chapter number 26, I want to start reading at verse 36. Then cometh Jesus, are you there?
Amen.
With them to a place called Gethsemane, and he said unto the disciples, sit ye here while I go and pray yonder. And he took with him Peter and the other two sons of Zebedee and began to be sorrowful and very heavy. Then said he unto them, my soul is exceedingly sorrowful, we can go and pray.
Yes.
Now, y'all listen to me.
Amen.
Now, he asked his disciples this one small favor. Throughout his dissertation here, for 3.5 years, he really didn't ask these boys for much of anything. Come on and talk to me this morning. He didn't ask them to go get him no water. He didn't ask them to do much for him, because most of the time he did everything for them that they needed to be done.
Amen.
He provided for them.
Amen.
He taught them. There was one occasion where somebody, the crowd was so great, and because of his compassion, he didn't want to turn the crowd away. So he said, I got to feed these folks.
Yes.
And so he said, is there any food among us? And somebody said, young lad, about 12 years old, said, I got 2 loaves of bread and 5 loaves of fish. Jesus said, can I have it? Give it to me. Bring it hither. And he took that and fed 5,000 people.
Yes.
Not including the children.
Amen.
Oh my God.
Yes.
So you see here, he was a compassionate God, so compassionate that he didn't have no problem feeding the 5,000. And then on another occasion, he fed 4,000. Oh, praise God. And so, whatever he asked, whenever the disciples needed something, he would always supply whatever they needed.
Amen.
Are y'all with me this morning?
Amen.
There was another occasion, because Jesus was a just man, one of the disciples came to him and said, Master, we need to pay our taxes. Oh, help me here today. And so Jesus said, we don't have it. He said, no, we don't have it. He said, well, I tell you what you do. Go down to the lake. Hallelujah. And reach down deep. Hallelujah. And the fish that you draw up, the hook that's in the fish's mouth that you draw up, open his mouth. And when you open his mouth, there'll be enough money in there that will be able to pay the taxes, and we can go ahead on and render unto Caesar what's due to Caesar.
Amen.
I imagine that they probably looked at him like he was nuts, praise the Lord, or one brand new fool. Come on, amen. Who in the world ever thought about looking in the mouth of a fish? God help me here.
Yes.
Amen. In the mouth of a fish to find money. Well, they did what Jesus asked them to do, praise God. The total was, you know, that was what Jesus said do. Amen. So they went and did, and they opened the fish's mouth, and there was money to pay the taxes.
Amen.
Touch your neighbor right quick and say, hey.
Hey.
Hey, hey, hey.
Hey, hey, hey.
Guess what? Jesus. Come on, look at your neighbor. Look at your neighbor. Jesus. Provided a fish.
Provided a fish.
With some money in his mouth.
With some money in his mouth.
Oh my God. Let me tell you something. He's still doing that.
Yes, he is.
Yes, he is.
Amen. But the fish is in a different connotation than what it was back then.
Amen.
Because I know that some of y'all have gone in some places where you've tried to get a loan and they told you no flat out, or you got your application filled out.
Yeah.
And then you were directed to go to another place to fill out the same loan, same amount of money, and look what God did. He opened the door.
Amen.
So what is that, Bishop? That's a fish. There's money in the fish's mouth. Only
right.
It's a different bank.
That's
PC,
right.
PCB, amen. Chase, Huntington, amen. USA of America, hallelujah. Church of God, God's still got a fish with some money in his mouth.
Amen. Amen.
Now that's what the Bible says he did, and I believe it, and I got crazy enough faith to believe that that if God did it for them, praise the Lord, he can do it for me. So I'm going to tell you this morning, praise God, if you're in need of some money, all you got to do is just find yourself a foot, a fish, and open his mouth. Open. Don't y'all look at me like that. Now, I told you, the fish is not going to be like you expected it to be where Jesus was concerned, but it'll be in another totally different way. Because Jesus made mention of the fact that the heart of the king is in the hand of the Lord, and he turneth it whichever way he will. Now, I know that every last one of you all that are sitting here under the sound of my voice has not always been able to go out and do exactly what you wanted to do, and it came right into fruition like you were looking for it to be. Because there's been some battles, some ways that have been made. But I come to let you know this morning that you serve a God, if you serve him, and if you know him, and if he's your God, you